Welcome to course 453, International Organizations. Study Section 9, Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. Introduction. Oil is one of the world's most utilized energy resources, yet only few countries have it in commercial quantity. Since 1960, some of the world's leading oil-producing countries have come together under one banner to speak with one voice with regard to the price of crude oil market through the establishment of Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, in the 1960s. We will therefore devote our discussion on the formation, purpose, and challenges of OPEC in this study session. Learning outcomes. When you have studied this session, you should be able to 1. Outline the rationale behind the formation of OPEC. 2. State the broad purposes of OPEC. 3. Describe the organs of OPEC. 4. Explain the challenges facing OPEC. Formation of OPEC. The Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, is a cartel organization formed by developing countries whose economies rely on oil export revenue. OPEC has become a formidable force in the international terrain since its formation, realizing the leverage determination of price of oil through regulation of supply would give them in international politics. Some oil-producing countries came together in 1960 to form OPEC. Its formation started with the convening of an Arab Petroleum Congress in April 1959 in Cairo. As contained in the second resolution, the Congress suggested that the government of the oil-producing state should from time to time exchange views on measures for the conservation of oil resources and their proper exploitation and other such matters for the purpose of coordinating the measures taken by the individual countries and ensuring the regular flow to world markets, cited in Azam 1963. Further consultation between Venezuela and some of the Middle East countries led to the invitation issued by the government of Iraq to Iran, Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, and Venezuela to attend a conference in Baghdad in September 1960. Following the discussions of various mutual petroleum problems, the conference reached an agreement to form a permanent body for common petroleum policy. According to the preamble of the Baghdad Agreement, the participants, considering the importance of petroleum as a vital source of income for their development programs and for the balancing of their budget, that oil was an expendable source of income which needed replacement, that it was an important source of energy for the world, and that the stability of prices was necessary, and found it advisable to form a permanent institution to be called OPEC, cited in Azam Ibid. OPEC has 4/5 of the world's proven crude oil reserves, nearly 850 billion barrels. Therefore, it is reasonable to assume that the organization will supply most of the crude to the market in the years ahead, a market in which oil is expected to remain the leading energy source. Aims of OPEC. 1. Unification of petroleum policies for member countries individually and collectively. 2. Consultation among its members with a view to coordinating and unifying the policies and determining, among other matters, the attitude which members should adopt, whatever circumstances, such as those referred to reduction of the posted price of crude oil in the Middle East by major oil companies, have arisen. In 1968, in a move that was meant to assert itself in the oil market, OPEC issued a declaratory statement on petroleum policy. First, OPEC wanted more control over pricing policy. Its members wanted to be price makers, not price takers. Second, its members described their roles as tax collectors who allowed oil companies explore their oil resources. Evans and Newham, 1997. Since the 1970s, OPEC's capacity for action has improved from a situation where it negotiated prices with oil companies to a situation where it can improve prices unilaterally. Another tactic it employs is to set production limits that specify how much oil may be produced by each member. Throughout the 1970s, countries of OPEC cooperated to control the price of oil by agreeing on production limits and succeeded in changing the structure of the international economy. In 1973, for example, OPEC successfully quadrupled the price of oil, causing a significant economic transformation that shook the foundations of the global economy. Cabo and Ray, 2011, page 72. Through the use of commodity power, huge sums of money were passing from the hands of the economically developed countries to the less developed countries. This occasioned a lot of changes in international trade and finance, as well in international security thinking, due to the economic and security importance of oil. Activities of OPEC affected the industrial capacities of developed countries and created a deeper sense of interdependence in the global community. Organs of OPEC. According to the OPEC Statute 2008, the following are the organs of OPEC. 1. The Conference. It is the supreme authority of the organization. 2. Board of Governors. It is responsible for the affairs of the organization and the implementation of the decisions of the conference, as well as consider and decide upon any reports submitted by the Secretary General, draw up budget for the organization. It is presided upon by a chairman. The secretariat shall carry out the executive functions of the organization under the direction of the Board of Governors. It is headed by the Secretary General, who is the legally authorized representative of the organization. Challenges facing OPEC. Continued advances in technology, together with price defense policies, have encouraged the rapid development of non-OPEC oil and have helped perpetuate this long-standing imbalance. In the short term, non-OPEC producers are taking the lion's share of the market, to the extent that even the IEA has observed that OPEC has a problem with the loss of its market share, but there is a limit to this process, and this is provided by the absolute quantity of non-OPEC reserves. In the not-too-distant future, non-OPEC output will reach a plateau. But this imbalance is the reason why the organization strives so hard to achieve concrete cooperation with its non-OPEC counterparts. Over the past decade or so, oil's traditional dominance has been put under pressure on environmental grounds, particularly in the context of the UN-sponsored climate change negotiations. There have also been longer-standing efforts among some consuming nations to diversify energy sources away from oil on so-called strategic grounds. The chief beneficiary of all of this has been gas. Also, OPEC as cartel organization has to find ways to effectively ensure that member states abide by the quota allotted to them in order for them to be able to control the price based on the economic principle that price falls when quantity supplied exceeds quantity demanded, and vice versa. Most of the oil exporting countries depends on the sale of oil for foreign exchange earnings. They tend to sell as much as they can to be able to finance projects at home. Also, governments of most of the member countries of OPEC are not in control of oil production due to their poor technological capacity. Most of these governments only collect rent from multinational corporations that are directly in charge of production. This predisposes them to excessive controls from the multinational corporations and renders the government incapable of regulating the oil sector. Furthermore, some members of OPEC are among the heavily indebted countries, HIC. This leaves them at the mercy of their creditors, who they may not be ready to offend with their activities as members of OPEC, given the fact they were also asking for debt forgiveness or debt relief. Moreover, OPEC does not enjoy membership of all countries that are producing and exporting oil in the world. Thus, there tend to be competition between OPEC official policies and activities of non-OPEC oil exporting countries. Finally, one of the difficulties facing oil producers is that their rich endowment of heavily demanded natural resources means that the international spotlight will always be focused on them, and very often in a negative manner. Study session summary. In this study session, we discussed that OPEC is an international oil cartel formed by world oil exporting countries to regulate price of petroleum products through the regulation of supply. OPEC has over the years become an important organization to reckon with because the importance of petroleum in the economies of developed countries. The organization became a channel for the distribution of capital from the developed countries to developing ones. However, inability of the organization to strictly enforce quota allotted to each member country has at one point or the other led to overproduction of oil glut, thereby making it difficult for the organization to be in control of the price of petroleum in the international market. This is the end of study section 9. Thanks for listening.